Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Dark Souls. Last time, we beat on Orlando, got ourselves the Sun Covenant, got ourselves the Lord Vessel. Also blew up Guinevere and slew Gwendolyn with our new weapon, Quaylag's Fury Sword, as we are an Agent of Chaos we are a wielder of flame, after all. Oh yeah, heading back to good old Undead Asylum! Yeah. Also, Delica judges us harshly. Above Firelink Shrine, above here, in this tower, in this nest, let us go back to the start and head to our next area. Okay, skip the cutscene because you're already seeing a four. Skip. And wow, a ton of damage. And let's see if Snuggly spawned up. Snuggly spawning? Yes, you do.
You give me warm. Give me soft.
Anyways, we'll talk with her later. Snuggly is a character who's very famous in Dark Souls and known for appearing a lot throughout the games. Also, by the way, if you notice, the floor is a little bit more uneven, if you pay attention. We could have fought this guy as early as when we first came back to this place and got the Rusted Iron Ring, but I chose not to. This freaking bonfire, though. Never say that. What's a two with a fire whip on you instead of a. We'll have it fire up. That's fire up. That. And head to the middle. And fall through the floor into the boss against the stray demon. Okay, so there's a magic attack. Oh god! He has a demon catalyst. And he landed on my flames. Down goes the stray demon. Victory achieved. And from that, we get a ton of humanity, a homeward bone, and a titanite slab. Also, we should get a ton of souls now. 2,000. And we get a soul. Not that we get a humanity, but anyways. The titanite slab. There's only four of them in the game, naturally. That's not a drop from an enemy. Legendary slabs were the domains of the gods. Legendary slabs, the heirlooms of the nameless blacksmith deity who forged the weapons of the other gods. Weapons for this slab become legendary, rare weapons. We don't have the means to make them anyway, so. But now, we need to leave this area. And we're going to fight a couple black knights. There's two. Two here. For one, there's one here. In front of our cell, which by the way is named Anton. Because fun fact, this guy has a name. And this is the, because of a comic called The Age of Fire. And he's dead. John. Yep. A named character from a comic who ended up getting killed in the Undead Asylum as that guy. And here is the doll! The peculiar doll is important for getting into. Also, here's the Lord Vessel. Lord Vessel bestowed at the Chosen Undead, which is designed to be the Lord Gwyn. The Chosen Undead is granted the Art of War Deep Bonfire. So open the final door, place his vessel on the Firelink Altar, and fill it with powerful souls. And over here, the peculiar doll. A strange doll in a strange dress. There was once an abomination, but no place in this world. She clutched this doll tightly, and eventually was drawn to a cold and lonely painted world. We'll find out more about that abomination later. Though I don't really want to call them an abomination. But yeah, now we know that demon that was there that entire game. Kind of just stomping about. Punch, punch. Alright. Got the doll! We already killed Oscar, so we don't have to worry about that. We have to kill one more enemy. Sword of the Black Knight to Wander Lordran, used to face Chaos Demons. Large motion puts the weight of the body into the attack, reflects the great size of the Rap series long ago. Okay, that's all of them. Yep, literally all of them. Now I'm gonna head to Blighttown again, so I can get to myself another Pyromancer. Gain as much Pyromancer strength as possible. Okay, welcome to the Daughter of Chaos again. Alright, I decided to use Aengi, because Aengi can do stuff like that, so. I have plus 14, Pyromancer Flame. So, I might want to get my Pyromancer Flame, Fireball. Oh, yeah, by the way, talk to Anastasia, I think. No.
Thank you.
No. Sorry, Anastasia. With the great fire orb, because we're going to be heading into the ruins. Oh my god! Like to drop transient curses like they're made of butter. I should really say like they're I don't know actually. They eat them, I guess. Now we head to the Wander Ruins. The only thing about it is that there is no bonfires in the Wander, so you want to be very careful. And then step off, just so I can get it back up there, so we don't burn you. Burn you. Now, on our way into this place, we'll meet a friendly face. The Crestfallen Warrior. He has also gone hollow. all because his place was disrupted. He was beginning to like it too. And then he went home. Oh my god! That's the problem with Pelex Fury Sword, is that it's a very, very easy pair. It's the most time ever in the Dark Souls. That you could now put their changing curses and start getting forward. I'm just gonna say this, the ghosts aren't that hard. I mean, most people that might be able to overstate how hard they are. For me, they are not that hard. You just gotta kinda hit them really hard. Just kinda kill them. And you go. Dagger is a dagger that uses a buckler. Okay, she destroyed it right now. This dagger is useful. It's useful after parrying. It is normally equipped in the left hand. A favorite of the Knights of Kareem, more famous for fighting Banish Shield. Also, Jagged Ghostblade, I'm surprised I got, because that's a 2% drop. A little bit of the Silver Knights, but no. Oh, I got it. Grab that. Grab that. Oh, Ghost Ladder. I'll make a pathway, a little shortcut for us. Some units. Climb down. Which now I can roll off the top of that area to here. Basically get a little shortcut. Ways other than transient curses, there are no. There is okay, kill it. There are again other ways, but the main way to kill it is okay. Okay, okay. I'm surprised the transient curses aren't worn out yet. That's a dead end, so. I guess they likely shortened it in the remaster. Again, most of my experience from Dark Souls comes in the remaster, so. Yeah. So. There's that. Okay, that's a dead end. Careful falling in the water. That is a bottomless pit. You will drown. Oh, yeah, so only a soldier. Nice. You're Sunny D. Approach the house, there should be some ghosts that come out of the water. Okay. I see, in here. Right? I forgot how freaking. The problem with this is that it's slow. Start using my shield more. Okay, that's a wrong item. And here and kill this banshee. This banshee is a rare monster thing, because it can drop, there's only two in the game, and they can drop a 1% weapon called the Ghost Blade, which is one of the rare ones that's on the game. Last keeper of the seal. The only one who did not abandon
well,
his post.
This is a surprise.
One
I
went to evil, one to the light contract, help him if he died.
You have the Lord Vessel. Very impressive. I know exactly what your intentions are. You seek the four kings whom I guard over.
A fun fact
this
about Ingward.
Is the key to the seal.
Ingward had a cut quest. You see that area in front of him? Yeah, that was supposed to be a lot bigger, and it was supposed to have an actual boss in it, which is one of the undead kings. Not a four kings, but one of the undead kings, Jarl. Which Jarl would have been a boss, and they'd see you fought, and then he would give you the key to the seal. Instead of just being like, oh, we got it here.
The four kings slumber in the deepest chamber of the ruins. Use this key to break the seal and open the floodgates. Oh, and do not forget, the dark wraiths reside in a dark void called the Abyss. But the Abyss is no place for ordinary mortals. Although, long ago, the knight Artorias traversed the Abyss. If you can find him and learn from him, the Abyss may prove surmountable.
Sadly, he's dead. And we had to get the
Hello
of his son. Of
what is it?
Child,
the key to the seal is now in your hands. I will help you in any way possible.
Anyways, we can also break curses from him for free. We can purchase transient curses from him and a resist curse. A new miracle. Or magic. Sorcery of the Red Robe Remedician. Ingward is guarding the seal of Nulando. Sacrifice humanity to undo curse. Abhorrent curses eat away at the core of one's very essence, and cleaning oneself of curses is no easy task indeed. So you might want to pick curses as well.
New Londo was sacrificed to contain the Dark Wraiths. Mark my words, the Dark Wraiths are the enemies of man and any living thing that has a soul. They were never meant to roam again.
Dark Wraiths are
New
Londo enemies
was
of humans.
Sacrificed to could mark my work. They
enemies of humans, Dark Wraiths. The Dark Wraiths are not as cut and dry as that, but they are proven to be very malicious. I forgot to the seal, the key. Kill the seal. Kill the fuck is Nulando, which is close. Key to the new flood against Nulando, which sealed away the four kings who fell to the dark. The sealers flooded Nulando to banish the dark race of the four kings. The agonized decision was made with the realization that countless lives and the robust culture of the city would be lost. The victims now ruins as ghosts. There is also the one blade I forgot to read. The Ghost Blade. Which is a... Jagged Ghost Blade is a curved sword, by the way. Jagged Blade wielded by the Nulando Ghost. It's violent thrust attacks. One of the cursed weapons inflicts damage to ghosts. Because yes, it does damage ghosts, but its strength is scaling, so... Bad. Come down here, you coward! Ow, my face. There. Strikes all takes. I also do think the four kings are weak to fire. She's pretty useful. There. And this way. The other way I was going. Step out of here is the way forward. Over here is where you sort of get an item. Give yourself the curse by ring, which helps prevent the curse build up. One of the infamous rings to commission by Sir Astor Kareem, despite the dreadful rumors surrounding its creation, the ring is an unspeakable asset for the ability to help fight curses. Alright, they're king dead. Wait, the seal, by the way, there. Go up here. Head around to the very end. More item. Humanity. By the way, just letting you know, if you die, you go back all the way to Firelink, just to warn you. You want to get that seal before you leave. It's a pretty long trek back. Get it, long trek. Long trek. Anyways, over here is a rare ring of sacrifice. So it was an orange juice. I love orange juice. Also, go up, go upstairs first before you go down. Because up here should contain. Bum ba dum ba bum! The strongest bow in the game, the composite bow. Not the longest range, the fairest bow is that, but the composite bow does the most damage physically. D5 damage, pretty good for a dex weapon. Composite bow emphasizes power, requiring more strength than standard bows. However, its range is shorter, making it unfit for sniping. But if you want a bow for PvP, use the sniper, use the composite. Anyways, flip, contraption does not move. That is the elevator down to the seal, but anyways, open this is the key to the seal. And let's turn the seal. The new Londo Water Park stops today! The new Londo Water Park starts today! What's out? As the entirety of new Londo empties. Ow, my hand. Just cracked my hand. Ow. So we get to meet the so you all know, a lot of people die here. A lot of people die. Also, I'm on fire. Light the drink on fire. Famous shields, rings in the game, basically, at lower HPs, you do more using the opposite of blue tier stone. Red tier stone called tier stone has a gain ability sensitive to death. This red tier stone from Korean boosts that the wearer, the attack was wearing when in nature. Pretty useful, and there's the brigand armor. No boys. Knowledge war by the brigands from raid mountains and hamlets attack villagers. Use the metal over the base cloth and leather offers agility defense. Yeah, that's all, folks. By the way, up. no. Be right back. Okay, two dragons left. Or one dragon left, should I say? Drake. Drakes are pretty annoying. Play the area. Dealt with. Alright. New London ruins. Residence? Yeah, it didn't even stop them. The Dark Raids continued on. They have their own new thing called the Dark Hand, which is basically made of white fronting. They also can drop Titanite chunks and Titanite slabs very rarely. Good. They aren't too hard to beat if you fought a Dark Knight, you fought the one of them. The only thing is that they can suck up your humanity and it hurts. I think this is the boss arena that would kill the boss if he exists anymore. If he did not exist. Oh, freaking my body! I think through all that crap again. Now, there is a thing that spawns wisps, which is very conscious of. Here. Oh, hell, there. That's it, by the way. By the way, here is what you want to do, set it up as Fire Link. Come over. Come over. There's humanity here too. Thank you. Give me humanity. Well, Dancing Blade Attack. Am I showing mine? It's called Instat Max Stab. Chunk. So, up through here, a bunch of transient curse. Or not. Or actually, use a transient curse. Because over here is a skull, so a great warrior. Come on. Around. I think I miss. Side door. Okay. I definitely missed it, but. Oh, no, I didn't. Head up these steps. There we are. With our thing in hand. A banshee might seem like it's no longer here, but we can get the very large ember. Basically, I'm bringing a weapon to plus 15. Surprised there wasn't that guy, but the banshee there. Nice. tell it's a covenant. This, the Dark Wraiths are. Because yes, they are a covenant. They are a soul-sealing covenant that takes the soul of others. Say out of your lord's room. Grab yourself a tiny chunk. And now we have access to yourself with some gas fireballs as well. Alright, there's another mass of souls. Dark hand. Just letting you know, I completely had my finger off the trigger. I don't know why I kept hitting. I was pressing the B button. That was the roll button. I was trying to roll off the cliff. I think it was in some space, and it didn't have a picture. So, okay then. I'm not human yet. Okay. Here? safe. Hey, use that if you're going for a more faster shortcut than I'm gonna give you. Ooh, a dark hand, that's a rare drop. That's a rarity. That's literally, I cannot even describe. In a rarity, I mean, like, literally, that is a 0.1. Oh, wow, you're fast. So, drink your Sunny D, head towards here, get rid of your bellowing dragon crest ring. Now, equip yourself with instead the Covenant of Artorias and full habits. Yep, full habits. Fat rolling doesn't really matter. Our shield will guard some of the damage. Should be fine. Maybe fat rolling, but it's not gonna matter too much. Right now. Because we interacted with Beatrix, I forgot to get her. Okay then. This is gonna be interesting. This is a DPS test. Now, I forgot to get with Beatrix, so I'm not gonna have her in the boss fight. Well, tough crap. Okay, crap. Be right back. What I did was basically use some souls. I realized I had well over 47,000. I didn't need to spend that. Anyways. So I spent it on a point of endurance. The real important thing is I upgraded my Pyromancer to a plus 3. Now we can actually send it out. Here, now There she is. Witch Beatrix, come and help me. Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell about Darkhand. Darkhand is technically classified as a shield, by the way. You can't find it. Or never mind, it's kind of a fist weapon. Darkhand. 200 damage, pretty good physical protection. Against most everything, basically. And 30 utility, pretty good. The Dark Wraiths, incited by Kath, use the power of the Dark Soul to absorb humanity, an art shared by this weapon, which also acts as a special shield. The ancients particularly could sap the humanity of even a reptile saint in the blink of an eye. A replete saint. Yeah, they're basically parasites. Now, why they do it, we'll find out. For now, let's use humanity and just use it. Anyways, boss right now. The cover mortuary is equipped. Yes. You won't be surprised at how many times people fall into the abyss, expecting they actually have the Covenant of Artorias on and then don't. And then die. That's a lot. It never happened to me because I usually count the next one. Because if you don't, you will die the immediate moment you land on the ground. Because here is where the abyss ends, and our fall begins. Let's go. We face off against the four kings of Melinda. The abyss. Welcome to the abyss.
Why are you looking for the sun in the abyss?
Alright, four kings. One of them spawns in, rushes towards you. You use your shield. Get up close and personal. Basically, start spamming fireballs. So that's an explosion attack, which hurts. And, hurts for that. It's basically the best way to use a DPS attack. Keep up with the DPS and you should be fine. Thank you. death animation. Or they explode. Soul of the four kings who fell to the dark. If I went to Lord's soul, the scout would be agent on the fire. Lord Gwyn recognized the foresight of these four great leaders of New Londo and granted them at the ranks and fragments of a great soul. Though this is not a full Lord's soul, it can still satiate them. Yes, that was the Lord already filling it with the souls of. Well. Not the first one. Like this?
Souls, but your progenitor found a fourth, unique soul, the Dark Soul. Your ancestor claimed the Dark Souls and waited for fire to subside. And soon, the flames did fade, and only dark remained. Thus began the Age of Men, the Age of Dark. However, Lord Gwyn trembled at the dark, clinging to his Age of Fire and in dire fear of humans, and the Dark Lord who would one day be born amongst them. Lord Gwyn resisted the course of nature by sacrificing himself to link the fire and commanding his children to shepherd the humans. Gwyn has blurred your past to prevent the birth of the Dark Lord. I am the primordial serpent. I seek to right the wrongs of the past, to discover our true Lord. But the other serpent, Frapped, lost his sense and befriended Lord Gwyn. Undead warrior, we stand at a crossroads. Only I know the truth about your fate. Must destroy the fading Lord Gwyn, who has coddled fire and resisted nature, and become the fourth Lord, so that you may usher in an age of dark.
What is our decision? Do we A, listen to the gods' plan and link the fire, prolong the age of fire, if only for a year or a few months? Which Gwyn is doing its nature, because after us is our turn, it's humans, humanity's turn. Because Kath is in fact speaking the truth. And I'm gonna say that Kath speaks the truth, Framp speaks lies. But here's the thing. Both are creatures of the abyss. Both seek their own path. Both have their own agenda. I am gonna say that. Framps is honest, he wants to help Gwyn. Kath is different. Kath seeks to feed the Dark Soul again. To complete the Dark Soul. By killing as many humans as possible and collecting their humanity. And also to, well, usher the beast of the Abyss. But anyways, yeah. Anyways, that's one of the Beast of the Abyss, by the way, they mentioned. I'm gonna go yes. Because Fram speaks the truth, and as we learn through later games, the Age of Man is the right course, which is go. Because if we prolong the Age of Fire, we'll bring it to the world. So, yes.
Very well. I shall now guide you to Gwyn's prison. Be
also,
still.
Also, because we see what happened to people who,
And trust thine flesh to
We also
me.
See what happened to people who do abuse it. Coming dark wraiths. Coming slaughtering everything. And those who are, oh, by the way, Kath basically takes us to the manifest of occasion by, freaking eating us.
The Lord vessel upon the altar.
Yeah. Though I am going to follow him. Also, there's the fact that the Abyss technically isn't really good for humans as a species. You'll see when we do the DLC, but you see what happens when the Abyss touches a human. Though that can also be interpreted as the main villain of that DLC, manipulating humanity and humans to mutate them to in order to get revenge against the Abyssal seal or against Gwyn. One or the other. Anyways.
What is it? Place the Lord vessel upon the altar.
But wait, but Kath seems to have his own agenda, but it's also seeing to work with you. Which is the thing. Kath is choosing you. Kath wants to work with you. Also, re-equip actual, natural gear, narrow beams, because... Some Dragon Crest, some your, Shadow Leggings, your Serpent Gauntlets, your, Knight's Armor, and your Crown of Wings. And the person using the same build.
Once the vessel is filled with souls, the gate to Gwyn shall open. Seek Gravelord Nito, the Witch of Izalith, and the traitor, Seath the Scaleless. Fill this vessel with their souls. Then the gate will open so that you may kill Gwyn. Are you ready? Then... Let us return to the Abyss.
I just realized, will this kill me?
And trust
I know that,
if,
I think after
to
the four
me.
Kings, the Abyss becomes safe for you, because you technically get a covenant with the creatures of the Abyss by, being a friend of Kath. but I might die the moment I get back.
Maybe you should have been wearing the ring of our toys. Stupid idiot.
Alright, yeah, we're safe. Anyways, with Cat.
If you wish, I shall grant the art of life drain, the legendary power of the Dark Lord. It can preserve your humanity while undead, and cast off the shackles placed upon your brethren.
Now we can enter a covenant, which is the Darkstalker Covenant. The Darkstalker Covenant, or the Darkwraith Covenant, which is basically a PvP covenant that basically deals with enemies. Anyways, Darkwraith Covenant, I think you can get some pretty good gear from it, including the Darkwraith Sword and Armor. And you also get the Dark Hand as a shield. You also buy Rhino Orbs from him, too. The Dark Hand at offering 1, which gains by the Life Steal, and at maximum, you can steal, at 60 offers of humanity, you can steal 10 humanity with the grab. Oh, I know, you get the Red Eye Orb for doing that, which is not a cracked Red Orb, because it's less than evade players forever. But I'll wait for that.
To speak now is premature. It begins with your retrieval of the Lord Vessel. They failed. Every last one of them. They were strong. Saw not the truth.
There were others.
I am certain that you will prove different. They failed. I am certain.
So the other ones are victorious.
Farewell.
Anyways, let's go on to Daughter of Chaos. Also, Framp is no longer interactable. He will leave. Basically, like, okay, screw you then. You won't. You want the fire? I'm gonna screw. Like, screw off. I'm gonna go all over here. Anyways, there's more stuff we can do here, but I want to do some things. We're gonna be next heading to the valley to fuck to the valley of, well. The next area is going to be the Demon Ruins, mainly because I do want to do this, but I want to probably get ahead there right away just to get the covenant done with, but I do want to get my, sad people. The problem is we couldn't have talked to him, because the moment we talked to him, he would have taken us to the Lord Vessel, and he would have, we couldn't be able to cash him in. The saddest thing about it, because I would have headed into there, grabbed those two things, and ran all the way back to Anor Londo, which I didn't want to do. No, for obvious reasons. Oh my god, I just realized our stamina. Holy crap. How did you use so much stamina to that boss? How much stamina does this thing take to swing? Not that much. Oh, I get it. Pavel's armor. Pavel's armor takes stamina.
I would.
I have a favor to ask.
Yes.
My mother, the Witch of Izalith, was one of the primeval lords. Her power came from the soul that she found near the first flame. She focused this power to light a flame of her own. But she failed to control it. The flame of chaos engulfed Mother and my sisters and molded them into deformed creatures. Only I escaped. And now I am here. But my mother and sisters have been in anguish since. I beseech you, free Mother and my sisters from the flame of chaos. I cannot do it myself. I lack the strength and the bravery.
And the damage type.
I realize what I am asking. But please, free their poor souls. Mother's ambitions were misguided, no doubt. But surely 1,000 years of atonement is enough.
Yes.
Excuse me, I was so absorbed in thought I just drifted away. You see, I'm actually in a bit of a fix. I've made it this far, but I'm short on antidote moss for the trip back. By my knighthood, I'm ashamed to ask, but can you spare a few scraps of moss?
E3. Yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you. A saint you are. This Knight of Katarina expresses his deepest gratitude. I shall not forget this. Please, take this, a symbol of my appreciation.
I get the pure shield.
Well, our fates do seem entwined, don't they? Perhaps this, too, is the will of Lord Gwyn.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, man.
Poison swamp, like quicksand in there. The poison.
Alright. So next time I'm going to play I'll be back here. Sword to the falcon into a ultimate falcon, a bitter falcon. I'm trying to speak and I'm struggling. There we are. So give us feedback. Oh, by the way, I love the look of the retirement plan. This game feels chaos.
Well, I'll be. That's a brilliant ember you've got there. For all my years in the trade, that might be the finest. I'm just a
I've had a lot of
I'm just an old smith. I'd give my left arm for a gem like that.
It doesn't matter, it's like, oh, it's fine.
Well, thank you, Michael, for that. Now, just leave the rest to me. Andre of Astora gets the job done, you shall see.
So you should have found the Titan chunks, to get a plus 11. Anyways, next time we play Dark Souls, we're going to be heading into the Great Hollow. See you guys then. Have a great day.